Good morning, friends. In the last session, we had a discussion about programming language. Sir, what is mean by programming language? When we have to go for programming language, I explained very clearly. Generally, person-to-person communication is possible by using normal languages, and mission-to-mission communication is possible by using binary language. But when a person is interacting with the mission, a bigger problem we are going to face. To solve this problem, we are going for programming language. And I explained very clearly what is the main purpose of programming language and examples for that programming languages also. Okay. Then, meanwhile, sir, we have seen some programs. How to check whether the given number is a positive number or negative number, sir, by using if conditions I explained. And even, sir, how to calculate factorial of the given number also, I explained very clearly in the last session. Okay. Now, sir, even I explained the different types of programming languages available in market. Sir, what are all the different types of programming languages? Low level languages and high level programming languages and middle level. Okay. But anyway, it is highly recommended to go for high level programming languages nowadays. Then, sir, even we have seen some programs related to the arrays or list. So we have to read a list of values and we have to print. Sir, how easily we can write that program? Similarly, how to read a list of values and sort the elements according to the ascending order also I explained very clearly in the last session. Sir, read a list of values and sort the elements in descending order. Okay. Then read a list of values and calculate the sum of all the elements. So read a list of values and calculate the sum of even elements. So read a list of names and filter the names which are having the length, okay, which are having length, so greater than or equal to 5. So we have seen these kind of programs also in the last session. And then I explained translator. What is the main purpose of translator? Which is used for translation purpose, conversion purpose, where we can convert one type of data into type into another type of data. Okay. Sir, in general, these translators are available in the following forms, like assemblers, okay, like assemblers and even compilers, interpreters. Sir, when we have to go for which thing, sir, I explained very clearly. What is the main purpose of assemblers? To convert your low level instructions into high level instructions. Okay, low level instructions into, sorry, mission level instructions. If you want to convert such a type of things, then we have to go for these assemblers. Similarly, compilers. Compiler's job is also same, which is used to convert high level instructions into low level instructions. That is mission understandable format. So examples for compiler I covered, even we have seen example for interpreter. And I forgot to add one point. What is that? A node is nothing but, sir, Java is both compiled and interpreted programming language. So Java comes under both category. It is both compiled and interpreted programming language. Of course, it is not in our scope now. That's why no need to get much detail into it. Okay. Sir, up to this, do you have any doubts? Please confirm. If no doubts, we will go with the next concept, which is nothing but a compiler versus interpreter. Could you please confirm? Up to this, do you have any doubts, my dear friends? Please confirm. Up to this. Yeah, fine. Sir, now I want to explain the difference between compiler and interpreter. Okay, I want to explain the difference between compiler and interpreter. Sir, it is a very easy only, already we discussed it. What is mean by compiler? Very simple. The main purpose of compiler is to convert human readable code into machine understandable code. Okay, what is the main purpose of compiler? Sir, it is used to convert, H code. H code in the sense human readable code. Sir, human readable code into machine understandable code. This is the main purpose of compiler. Then, sir, it will scan the total program at a time. So it is going to scan the entire program at a time. Suppose if your program contains 10 lines of code, all these 10 lines it is going to scan at a time, not line by line. Whereas our interpreter is going to scan line by line. If there is any error, okay, sir, then we have to debug. Okay, we have to debug the errors. Okay, and suppose if there is, here in this case of errors, sir, all the errors will be displayed at a time. Okay, all these errors are going to be displayed at a time. And sir, example programming languages for this particular compiler based programming languages are nothing but sir C language, C++, Java, etc. These are nothing but example programming languages for this compiler. Okay, then so if when we have to go for compilers, of course it is not in our hands, but anyway, when the authors are implementing programming languages, they are going to finalize whether their programming language has to support a compiler or interpreter. Sir, one of the factor for deciding such a type of a feature is nothing but if any programming language is having more error rate. Sir, if error rate is very high, if the error rate is very high, sir, then recommended. Okay, recommended to go for compiler. So it is highly recommended to go for compiler. Sir, what about interpreter? Okay, what about interpreter? Sir, interpreter is also almost same like compiler. Okay, so what is the main purpose? It is used to convert. It is used to convert human readable code into machine understandable code. Sir, my purpose is I want to convert human readable code into machine understandable code. Then we have to go for this interpreter. Then, sir, it will scan the total program. It will scan the program line by line. Sir, it is not going to scan the total program at a time. It will scan line by line. Suppose if there is any error, then only one error will be displayed. Okay, at a time only one error will be displayed. Sir, only one error will be displayed at a time. If there is any error, then only one error will be displayed, and sir, we have to debug that for getting remaining errors. Okay, then example programming languages which provide support for this interpreter. Sir, do you know all the scripting level programming languages are going to provide support for interpreter? Python, Java, JavaScript. Okay, sir, shell script, shell programming. Okay, sir, shell scripting. So, etc. These programming languages are going to provide support. Sir, what about conclusion here? Very simple. If error rate is very low, there is no chance of getting any errors. Sir, then recommended to use interpreter concept. This is nothing but the difference between sir compiler and interpreter. Anyway, I want to explain these two scenarios with the help of an example program so that you people will get complete clarity. Okay, have a look once. Sir, what is the example program? I will go with the example program for compiler as well as for interpreter. First, let me choose compiler. Okay, sir, I want to create a simple program. Okay, I want to create a simple Java program. Let us take the file name as a test. Okay, sir, I'm going to save the file name as a test.java. It is already there. Replace it. Sir, I want to print some messages like hello one is nothing but my first message. So hello one, hello two, hello three, hello four, hello five. Like this, five times hello message I am printing. So to execute this, let us open command prompt. Sir, from here I am going to run the program. Sir, how to compile the Java program is nothing but Java C test.java. I am trying to compile my Java program. Yes, it is compiled successfully. I am taking Java space test. Yes, you are getting all the answers. Sir, in this case, sir, I am going to skip some instructions. Like here I am not taking this, and here I am not taking this, and here I am removing the semicolon. Sir, here I am not taking both the values. Like this, wantedly I created some errors. So when you are compiling the program, you can able to see all the errors at a time we are going to get. This is nothing but what is mean by, sir, compiler based programming languages. So you need to check all these four errors. You can able to see, sir, in the line number 6, unclosed string literal. Boss, you have opened the string, but you didn't close it. So unclosed string literal here also. Semicolon expected at the end. Sir, unclosed string literal. Like this, we are going to get errors. All the errors, it will be filtered and it is going to display. Sir, well and good. What about Python? Okay, what about Python? So how the behavior of Python will be there? Let me take one Python program. Yeah, sir, I want to take the same program in Python. So print off hello one. Okay, so print off hello two. So print off hello three. Like this, I want to print these statements on the output screen. Sir, same command prompt we can use. Sir, could you please confirm? So what is a command used to run the Python script? Please confirm. Which command is used to run the Python script? I forgot. Please confirm. I request every student to respond. Yeah, very good. So py space file name. What is the file name? Test. Test.py. Yes, we are getting all the five messages. No issues at all. Sir, I want to remove some syntactical things. Okay, I want to remove some syntactical things. And let me check, sir, what it is going to handle. Sir, only one error. Syntax error, end of the line while scanning the string literal. Sir, we got end of the line while scanning the string literal in line number 2. If you rectify line number 2, okay, then only line number 3 error will be displayed. Okay, so maybe it is a problem, but make sure that, so majority of the cases we are not going to get any errors. Majority of the cases we are not going to get any errors. This is nothing but what is mean by compiler and what is mean by interpreter. Sir, when we have to go for a compiler and when we have to go for interpreter. So hope it is very clear for you people. Sir, do you have any doubts up to this? Please confirm, friends. Do you have any doubts up to this? Please confirm. Sir, with this successfully, we completed the first chapter of our course. Okay, sir, which is nothing but introduction to the programming. Sir, till now I didn't started Python. Just we have started introduction to the programming. Meanwhile, n number of Python programs I covered very clearly. Okay, sir, probably this will be the last demo session. From tomorrow, the link is going to change. I request everyone to please be registered by today itself. Okay, so from today, for the register for those who registered for this course, they are going to get the videos. Okay, videos and running notes will be shared. So videos will be like this. So all the videos, okay, so like this we are going to get up to 3, 4. This is the fourth class, right, sir? Up to these videos and our running notes folder. Okay, our running notes folder is there, right? Yes, this complete folder I am going to share for you people today. Okay, a drive link. And moreover, from tomorrow the link is going to be changed. So register by today itself so that our admin team will share a link. Okay, yeah, sir. Now let me, before going to the second chapter, let me discuss some commands, I mean some programs, and then we will go with the chapter. Okay, so this is nothing but our second chapter. Yeah, so let me discuss some programs. Sir, what is the first program? Is nothing but, sir, program, okay, to generate, okay, program to generate random numbers, okay, random number, or I can use the word called generate OTP. What is mean by OTP? One time password. Okay, using Python. So write a Python program to generate one time password OTP value from, so our Python script, how you can able to generate, we will see now. Okay, shall we go, shall we continue? Please confirm. Yeah, so we don't want to write a big code. Kilometers of code is not required. Just one or two lines are sufficient. Okay, sir. Now, yes, let me ask you a question. Sir, how many digits of OTP you want? Please confirm. Is it a 2-digit OTP or 5-digit OTP or 6-digit OTP? Yes, please respond. 6-digit OTP. Yogesh is asking 6-digit OTP. Okay, sir, now I want to write a program to generate 6-digit OTP. Sir, it is a random number OTP, right? So I'm going to take a program, import random. There is one module is there with name random. Sir, in that random module, there is one function is there. What is the name of the function? Is nothing but randint. Randint. This is nothing but the function. But before going to this function, sir, you can able to find documentation of this function. It will give the complete description about this function, sir. If you want, you can able to see. Sir, py space test.py. Sir, what it is telling? It will return a random integer. It will return a random integer in the range of A to B, sir, including both endpoints. So it will include A value and B value. It is going to return a random number. Excellent. Now I want 5-digit or 6-digit OTP. Sir, you know very well the 6-digit OTP is going to start from this number, right? Yes. And it is going to end with 6 nines. That's all. Now it is going to generate a 6-digit OTP. Sir, this is the first time. Second OTP, third OTP, fifth OTP, sixth OTP. Like this, every time it is going to generate a different value. Okay, of course, you can store this OTP in one variable and you can send that OTP to the client by using either normal message or by using mail system. Then after receiving that particular message from the user, you can wait for 5 to 6 seconds or 5 to 6 minutes. Then the user is going to enter that particular OTP which was entered. Sir, you have that variable and user is giving some value. You can compare both the OTPs. If both are same, then you can give the credentials. Otherwise, you can say a message saying invalid OTP. Suppose if the time expires, then you need to destroy that OTP and you have to display a message saying, sir, time expired. Okay, in such cases, that OTP can't be verified. So like this, we can implement Python program. But if you want to implement the same logic in C or Java, of course, some 6 to 7 lines are required, but not this much simple, right? Then, sir, okay, fine. I want to write a Python program, sir, to find factorial of the given number. I think already I have explained. So Python program to find factorial of the given number. Sir, I explained very clearly in the previous session somewhere, okay? Sir, we need to import which module? Math module. In this math module, sir, we have factorial function is there. Sir, using this function, you can pass any integer value by using which we can find the factorial. Suppose if I am giving 5, it will return 5 factorial. 0, it will return 0 factorial. Sir, 3, it will return 3 factorial. Like this, we are going to get. This is nothing but what we have about a Python program. Okay. Sir, fine. Next step. Sir, Python program to find reverse of the given string or number. You can pass anything, either string or number, but your requirement is nothing but you have to calculate reverse. But in C language, in Java and Python, we need to write n number of instructions if you are going with the core concept. But if you are taking Python, sir, very simple. I told already, if you print yes, we will get a Prakash. Sir, if you want to print, so reverse of that number, colon, colon, minus one, you have to take. Sir, if you are taking colon, colon, minus one, then from the last character, it is going to fetch. Sir, it is something related to slice operation. It is something related to slice operation. I think somewhere I already explained about this, but anyway, in detail, we are going to discuss about this slice operator. It is waiting for input. Assume I am giving Java. I didn't save the program, it seems. Okay. Yeah, you can able to see. Sir, Prakash, I'm getting HSAKPR like this. Okay. This is the way how you can do this job. Okay. Sir, next. I want to implement one more program, sir, to check whether the given string is a palindrome string or not. Okay. Sir, palindrome string means what? If you take a string and if you take the reverse of the string, sir, if both strings are equal, so then we can use the word called those two strings are palindrome strings. Sir, I have one small question for you people. Sir, could you please confirm example strings for palindrome? Yes, please. So palindrome means even if you pronounce in the reverse manner also, it should be same. Such a type of strings. Do you have any idea? Very good. Ram Prasad is telling madam. Yes, very good. Kadak, radar, Bob, dad, mom, very good. Still, level, non, excellent. Ram Prasad, what is that? Still. Refer, excellent. Yeah, okay. I want to implement a program for that requirement. Okay, let us see how it will be. Sir, very simple. Sir, print a message saying palindrome when if s is double equal to s of colon colon minus 1. Yeah, Nayan, correct. So if s is double equal to s of colon colon minus 1. Otherwise, sir, print a message saying not pali. Sir, you have to supply inputs from your screen. Okay, suppose if I am giving the input as a madam, yes, it is the palindrome. Sir, if I am giving sir, not palindrome. Okay, suppose if I am giving level, yes, palindrome. Okay, sir, if I am giving something like Malayalam, yes, it is the palindrome. Okay, like this, we have some palindrome sing strings are there. Sir, how you can check that part? I explained with the help of conditional operator. Sir, Python program to check. Whether the given string is palindrome or not. Okay, sir, hope the concepts are very clear for you people. Sir, I think at least you got some confident on the Python programming, right? But don't worry, sir, in detail we are going to see each and everything. Okay, sir, if it is okay for you people, then I will go with our actual syllabus. So yeah, please confirm from your side. Sir, up to this you don't have any doubts, right? So you got the clarity how easy Python is. So I'm going to stop explaining the programs. Let us move. Yeah, no problem. Nothing. Just now we discussed only basics. Python had not started. Yeah, I request everyone to please confirm so that we will move. So you got the clear clarity how easy Python is, right? I mean, programs in Python. Yes. Sir, let me start about history of Python. Sir, our first topic related to the Python is nothing but history of Python. Are sir, what is this Python? Okay, what is this Python? Why we need to go for this Python? Sir, very simple. The first point, sir, remember every time I'm going to use this point for almost 10 to 15 classes. Sir, Python is very simple and easy programming language. Easy programming language. Sir, trust me, even you are going to feel the same after completion of minimum 5 to 6 sessions. Okay, make sure that Python is very easy programming language. Okay. Then, sir, one more point. In Python, everything is treated as, okay, everything is treated as an object only. So in Python, everything is treated as an object. So make sure that it is a complete, we can say that it is a complete object-oriented concept. Okay, it is a complete object-oriented programming. Next, sir, Python is high level programming language. Python is a high level programming language. Okay, then sir, Python is an interpreted, okay, an interpreted programming language. And sir, Python is general purpose programming language. Everywhere we are going to use this Python. So now it became very generalized programming language. Sir, then who developed this Python? Sir, Gudio Van Rossum. Okay, Gudio Van Rossum developed Python. Sir, when he developed Python? So 89, 90, like this, there are n number of alpha beta versions are there, but official date of birth of Python, official date of birth of Python is nothing but sir, 20th February. So 1991. Okay, sir, almost sir, 6 days after Valentine's Day he released Python. Remember, in that fashion, easy to remember. Okay. Right, then sir, while he is working for a particular mathematical project, sir, while Gudio is working for a mathematical project, he need a kind of a tool to work with mathematics. That's why, sir, he searched so many programming languages, sir, not that much comfortable he got. Then immediately he shifted his thought to develop a new scripting which will provide support for his project. So later it has been evaluated as a Python. Okay, sir, and moreover it has been upgraded. Okay, it has been upgraded, sir, from ABC programming language. He utilized the tools which is present in ABC programming. Yes, ABC programming is there. Sir, the main purpose of introducing this particular Python is nothing but for solving math problems, mathematical problems. That's why nowadays it is very useful in the data analysis area, data science area, in that areas. Okay, then, sir, Python is, I can use the word, sir, Python is very easy. Of course, from the first statement I am going to use, sir, because why? Sir, the programming syntax is very similar. The programming syntax is very similar, which is from C and ABC programming languages. And code reusability is there. Code reusability means what? Sir, existing code you can reuse. Then just the program statements are like, sir, just like English commands, whatever English are there, sir, just like English statements, we are going to write the commands. Okay. And nowadays, sir, Python became, okay, Python is a most popular, okay, most popular and trending programming language. Of course, you have to trust this word. Okay. Sir, if any person is trying to learn Python, okay, yes, you can recommend as a first programming language for the beginner. Okay, sir, Python is recommended as first programming language for beginners. If anyone trying to learn, okay, Python, then you can suggest it as a first beginner programming language. Okay, this is nothing but history of Python. Of course, from this you got only theoretical points, that's all, but remembering these things are very, very important, sir. Sir, next, Python official website, sir, could you please confirm what is the official website of Python? Do you have any idea? Please confirm. Very good. Very good. Excellent, people. Excellent. So https://, okay, sir, www.python.org is nothing but the official website of Python, sir, where you can get n number of things. Okay, where you can get n number of things, sir, if you want to just have a look once. So, and let me show you our Gudio Van Rossum, because we are a bit lucky, right? Because we have this Python beautiful programming language. Yeah, okay, Victor, no problem. Gudio Van Rossum. So he is nothing but Gudio Van Rossum. Okay, you can able to see him. Yeah, so born 31st January 56. Okay, then, so let us see the pictures. Yes, he is nothing but Gudio Van Rossum. Okay, sir, previously he worked for Google also. Sir, this is the official website of Python. Sir, where we can get the complete information, like, sir, about the Python downloads, what we have. Sir, have you observed? 3 days back, okay, sir, trust me, 3 days back, sir, I explained Python installation for one batch. there it was 3.9. Have you observed immediately 3.10 got released? Sir, don't worry. Trust me. I will explain all the new features which came in 3.10 as a separate session. One Saturday or Sunday I will take. Sir, what new things are there in the 3.10 with respect to programs I will cover. Okay. Documentation. You can able to see the documentation of Python. Sir, what is 3.9? Sir, it is in the pre-release, but they released immediately. Okay. If you want, you can see. Sir, what is the new things are there in 3.10? Sir, these are nothing but new syntaxes, new features. Okay. So, interpreter improvements and new typing features. Okay. And then removals, all these things and new features which came. Okay. Syntax errors, all these things, new concepts which they introduced. Anyway, all these things we are going to discuss. Don't worry at all. These are the new things, complete documentation they provided. Okay. Anyway, they didn't introduce new modules, but they introduced some, they improved some old modules, like sir, previously some modules are there in that they performed some kind of operations. Okay. Yes, don't worry. All these things we are going to discuss one by one. This is nothing but the official website from where we can get complete information about Python. For your understanding purpose, I want to tell one at least one difference. That's what I am searching. Yeah. Sir, you can see here. Have you observed? Expanded the math.gcd function to handle multiple arguments. So this is the improvement which made in which version? 3.9. Okay. In the 3.9, sir, they improved that. Sir, I will take a small Python program. So import math, sir, print of math.gcd, math.gcd of, sir, 10, 20. I want to check GCD of these two numbers. Yes, 10 is the answer. Suppose if I am taking multiple values, sir, how it is going to work? Let me check. Sir, it is working properly. But in which version it will work? Only in the 3.9 version. So this is the command which is used to run your Python script in the 3.9 version. Yes, it is working. Sir, I want to execute the same code in 3.8. Sir, we are getting error. What it is telling? Sir, your GCD function is expecting two arguments, but you have given 5. So, but same error we are not getting in the 3.9. Why? Because it is the improved version. Sir, I will explain one more example for you people related to this. Sir, we have square root of 5 is there. Okay. If you calculate a square root of 5, what will happen? It will return like this. Sir, I want only integral part. Then isqrt is there. Okay. But isqrt is not a old concept. Sir, it is a new concept. Suppose consider I want to execute in 3.8 and I want to execute the same program in 3.7. Sir, now you can able to analyze. Sir, could you please confirm in which version isqrt function is defined? Please confirm. From this analysis, in which version isqrt method introduced? I request everyone to respond. Yes, it is introduced in 3.8. Like this, version to version enhancements are there, sir. Okay. Anyway, we will discuss all these things. Sir, this is nothing but a Python official website, what we have. Sir, then where we can use Python. Sir, where we can use Python? Yes, Python everywhere we can use, sir. Okay, everywhere we can use. Sir, some of the applications. Krishna Raju, once if you set the path, everything will be available in the command prompt. Have a look once. In my machine, these are the installed versions. 3.9, 3.8, 3.7, 3.6, 3.5, 3.4. Sir, tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I'm going to explain 3.10 installation. Okay, once if the batch is regularized, I will explain the installation process. Sir, once if you execute the command, we will get 3.10 also. That part I will take care, don't worry, okay? Yeah. Sir, where we can use Python? Sir, we can use Python. We can use Python everywhere. Everywhere we can use, sir. Some of the application areas are desktop applications. We can use it in desktop applications, sir, web applications, okay, sir, data science applications, okay, then, sir, artificial intelligence application, sir, IoT, Internet of Things, okay, then, so even we can use in machine learning, and even we can use data analysis, okay, then deep learning, okay, in the testing environment, Selenium, in the testing domain, they are going to use, and even, sir, Django frameworks, okay, etc. In n number of ways, we are going to use Python, okay, in n number of ways, we are going to use Python. This is nothing but what we have, okay, sir, that's all. I'm not going to continue. Okay, sir, in the tomorrow's session, we will discuss about these things. What approach Python is going to follow, which companies are using Python, and why the name Python came, what are the different versions that we have, and how to execute Python programs in online compilers, how to execute Python program in offline compilers, and various commands used in Python execution process. And if possible, I will try to explain how to install the Python software. And immediately, I'm going to start third chapter also tomorrow. Okay. So, because we need to start our syllabus, right? That's why Python fundamentals, sir, comments in Python, keywords, identifiers, variables, constants, what are the naming conventions in Python, what flavors are there, features of Python. Maybe it will took some 2 days. Okay. Probably. Today is the Wednesday, right? So Thursday, Friday, we will finish this. Okay, sir, from Monday or Tuesday, we are going to start data types concept. Minimum 2 to 3 days must be required, and more attention must be required for this data types topic. Okay, yeah, sir, feel free to ask doubts, and please contact to this number immediately, and you need to register by today itself. Okay. So once if it is completed, then you are going to get the recorded folder and then running notes in the same drive. Okay, we are going to share. Yeah, today is the last date for demo class. Please register as early as possible. Okay, yeah. Sir, now that's all about today's session.